Dr. Sandy, I've heard you and many other experts talk about this concept of fight, flight, or freeze. And I'd like to know, how does that relate to me? And more importantly, how does that relate to my child?
Wonderful question, and so, so important that parents and everybody knows what fight, flight, and freeze are and why they happen. So when we are stressed, when our stress level has reached a really high, sometimes even toxic level because of all kinds of pressures in our lives, we are going to need some behavior in order to survive that stress. And the kinds of behaviors that we are going to resort to are fight, which means we will run towards whatever it is that's causing us stress, and we will fight with that. We could be fighting with mommy and daddy, we could be fighting with a bear. It's the fight survival behavior. The other kind of behavior we resort to when we are really, really stressed is flight. These are people who prefer to go, well, it's not a preference, but who just flee inwards in order to survive. And the flight is we withdraw from the world. We don't want to engage with others in any kind of conflicting way. And then there are those of us who, when we are stressed, will actually freeze. We don't want to take risks, we don't want to try anything new, we just take ourselves totally out of the situation because it is so overwhelming for us. What is really, really important as adults, we need to be aware that when we are in stress mode and doing our either fight, flight, or freeze thing, we are affecting our children. It is contagious. So when we are doing that, our children have absolutely no option other than to respond to us with fight or flight or freeze, whichever happens to be their survival mode. So moms and dads, I want you to know that actually there's another piece of information before I tell you that, and that is that look at all the diagnostic labels that children are being given. Let's start with oppositional defiance disorder, for example. That is a child who is overloaded with stress and is in fight mode. So if you want to heal oppositional defiance disorder, which really doesn't exist, you really need to just reduce the child's stress. And there will be no need for that child to fight. How many millions of children are being given a label of oppositional defiance disorder and no one's looking underneath and saying we need to take that stress away? Because when we do, the child will no longer be chemically driven to fight. Look at the flight issue. Children who are really stressed and in flight mode, what labels are they being given? Sad, depressed, social disorder, all kinds of things which indicate that they're withdrawing. Once again, that is not useful. We need to deal with the fact that this is a child who's in flight. So moms and dads, I'm hoping that this is useful to you in the sense, in several senses. First of all, for you to take a look at your own behavior, because you're actually teaching your children how to deal with stress in a dysfunctional way. Because fight, flight, and freeze are not the way we should be dealing with stress. That is pure survival mode. We cannot thrive in that mode. Secondly, when you see your child in one of those modes, please be aware. Look for the underlying root cause, which will be the stress, and see how you can reduce that stress.